We will sell our uniform, leave together.
I was about 21, 22 years old, and I was making music on my own, and I had the chance to win a contest in France with Les Inrecuptibles, which is the one of the big magazines, rock magazines in France. And there was a contest and you had to send one song and then the readers had to vote. And I won that, so it was a chance for me to meet some record label and stuff like that. So I made my first record like that. I mean, my friends barely listened to my music at the time, and it was the first time I
put yourself out there.
Yeah, because I didn't know anyone in this business, and I didn't know how to meet some people. I think I didn't realize yet that my job is completely opposite to what a shy person can do. Actually, I just didn't realize it. I mean, when I'm embarrassed or not comfortable, I just all red, and I can't take, I can't say a word, and I can't, I just sweat. It's great. It's beautiful to see. Some people, they say they are shy, but they're just, you know, quiet. But I'm really shy. I'm really intimidated by a lot of people. It's really strange. I can't really explain it. But when I'm on stage in front of an audience, I'm not scared. I'm just, okay, that's what I am. I met the director, Nicolas Klotz, during one of our shows. He was listening to the music, and he was looking for a band to make his soundtrack. I love the story, and it touches me deep inside. But it's great to see him work and to hear him talk about his art and his way of making movies. And I just wanted to make something with him. The only reason is that I don't know how to sing in French, and I don't know how to write songs in French. I think it's just another way to make music, and I don't know how to do it. It's really far more natural for me to write in English and to sing in English. I mean, singing in English doesn't mean you think in English. I didn't know, that was the first time that I hadn't a very clear view of what I wanted to do. I just wanted to be spontaneous on this record, so I just wrote songs. But I didn't record demos with a lot of arrangements, and I wanted to have like really simple songs, and then go to the studio and just try to be spontaneous and try to catch a moment. We recorded a lot of things live, and then when you have to overdub the stuff, we just wanted to take two takes instead of, you know, 20. When I finished this record, I just couldn't hear it. It was crap for me.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, but I think it's the... I was talking with Nicolas Klotz, the director from Heartbeat Detector, and he told me that you have to reject what you did, and then you go back to it, and then you listen to it with another point of view, and you understand why you did that and why you sang like that. And so I'm happy with these songs today, and that wasn't the case like 6 months ago. To me, ghost days are the days when I stay at home, so, and I just I don't go out a lot. I just walk around and play a little bit of music and compose something and write lyric down and so watch TV and then fell asleep and I wake up and it's 3 a.m. and I go eat something in my kitchen, then I come back and I write something. It's like ghost days to me because I don't see anybody and I just I composed all these songs in this period, this kind of period. I was asking myself, is something happening or am I just wasting my time? And I wanted to do something because that's my life. I spend a lot of time alone. For someone who don't play music or someone who has a regular job with regular timing, it's kind of being unemployed, I think. And I'm not unemployed. To me, it's like a real ghost day. I wanted to talk about ghost day, and Cloud Fakes is actually the first song I recorded as a demo for this album, and that was the starter for all the albums, the basis, and the lyrics are just about a ghost day.
Naked in the kitchen when everyone's sleeping tight, the clock goes to 7. I dance but I don't know why. I'm standing in the schoolyard waiting for my teacher to come. She looks gently downward and picks me up in the sun.